Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Angelica Steinacker. Also, this is still the fourth row.
There we go. It's all yours.
It's all mine. And I'm with IBM. I'm leading the identity and access management competency in Europe for IBM. And as I'm the one standing with you and the closing words of our host from KuppingerCole, I will make it short. And I promise I will not talk too much about IBM solutions, although we have great ones, of course. And several of my colleagues have done very good presentations on that, and I have put some links about these into the last slide of my presentation, so you will get all this information. But, and I have my cheat sheet here, because I have taken some notes from the very interesting presentations in the last 2 days. Today, I will give you only some food for thought on your way home, and perhaps something for the future to do. As I said, you have seen in the last 2 days, you had said it was the green button.
I pressed the green button for me.
The big one.
Okay, so you have seen in the last days a lot of interesting presentations, and as I said, I've taken a couple of notes which I thought at one or the other point are really fitting into the thoughts I want to present to you. And you have heard about the conflicting interests and requirements for consumer identity and access management. You have from lines of business and from security, from regulations, existing regulations, but also we have heard a lot in the previous call about the regulations, I would say, lurking in the bushes, like GDPR. So you have heard a lot of that. And what we are doing, or what I would say, we are talking about the consumer. But what with the consumer themselves? We are all consumers. We are all consumers, so we are talking about ourselves. What are with the consumers? I thought one interesting presentation was this morning from Cecil. She had said that they are working together with consumer organizations to learn from the one and the other, to get more direct representation of the users. So, what do you do as a company, as an organization, to communicate with your users about your effort to have a secure and trustful, trust, Ellen, you have said that, a trustful consumer consumer identity and access management. How do your consumers know that you are doing something for them? How can they decide on the quality of what we are doing, what you are doing for them? But you have not only heard about the requirements, You have not only heard about the requirements and the challenges, but also about solutions. Solutions, for example, for user experience, like risk-based authentication and multi-factor authentication. By the way, multi-factor authentication is compared by a very good friend of mine with a scarf and a hoodie you have to prevent you from the inclemency of the weather in the cyberspace, in the cyber weather. As well, you have heard about solutions for privacy by design, consent lifecycle management, security and fraud, and Martin Kuppinger has said this morning in the first session, he had said that still security with the, I would say, classical security functions is still something which has to be done there. And do we have a 360-degree view on consumer identity and access management now? Or is there something missing? And you know, if I'm asking this question, I will answer yes, there is something missing. And what do I think is missing there? Transparency. We have a lot heard about transparency. But it has different, I would say, different meanings, slightly different views into this topic. For example, as we have heard this morning, one to get the customer views, as Cecil has mentioned, but also others you have mentioned, Alan, just before, transparency, to have the user involved in the decision. And I would like highlight another view on transparency here. Let me start with an example I came across just last week. There is an organization in Germany, it is named Stiftung Warentest. And it has a magazine which is called Test, just Test. And this magazine, this Stiftung, they are testing a lot of consumer relevant things, like for example washing machines, but also something like contracts with company, for example telco contracts. They are testing these. And they are giving these things marks between 1 and 5, 1 the best and 5 the worst. And they have criteria how they assess these things, and they comprehensively describe their criteria in an understandable way. So every consumer can decide if these criteria are relevant for them or not, for a decision, for a buying decision. And in the latest issue, which has come out last week in December, for December 2017, wearables were tested. And here we get into the blurring area between consumer IAM and IoT, so in this space. And in this test, the testers have decreased, which really means devalued, all but one wearable by one grade, So from perhaps 2 to a 3 then, due to the lacking transparency of the conditions for the consumer and the lacking transparency of what is done with their personal data. So this example from real life, I would say, and this is just an example for lack of transparency. There are others, of course, like for example a consumer not having any insight into an organization's security features, or not an understandable insight into that. So how would we get to more transparency then? Tom has talked yesterday about speaking the right language yesterday morning, which I think is a start into that, which would be one of the points. And some regulations like GDPR, they ask for transparency. For example, Article 22, with the right of explanation. You have mentioned that too. But, and there is a very interesting article in the New York Times magazine from Cliff Kuang, and I really highly recommend to read this article, about this this GDPR article, and that is, this article is mainly only for data handled by machines algorithms. And this doesn't help you if a person handles your data. And it consent, as we have heard, needs to be given freely, informed and expressively, as Tim has stated yesterday. But how can a consumer, how can we decide that we are informed? And detailed information doesn't mean understandable information. And clarity and comprehensibility, I think, are main factors for transparency. How we get to that? Let me start with a citation on that. A citation from chapter 5 of a book, Data for the People, by Andreas Weigand. You have all these links in the last slide, so. And Andreas requests here transparency, what from he calls data refineries. With that he means each and every company which makes use and refines consumer data, like an oil or sugar refinery, are refining oil or sugar. And I think in that sense, all companies working on consumer data are data refineries. And Andreas requests transparency through rights, which he calls rights, the right to access data and the right to inspect data refineries, to inspect them. Which I believe is another important factor for transparency. So, how to deal with the demand for clarity and comprehensibility and the other factors, and what to do now? What to do? I do not have a final answer yet, but who has that at that point? But at least I would like to bring up some points for consideration. What is needed is some sort of dashboard, I think, based on a rating scheme similar to the one from the Test magazine I had mentioned before. And this would make it easier to understand and compare companies and their products for the consumer and their consumer identity and access management, and how they handle the data. How they handle the data. What do they do to deal with, for example, security attacks? So which criteria should be measured in a dashboard? Of course, criteria from the regulations we had been discussing before, and which are relevant for the company's products, as well as the contract and the cooperation with the consumer. Of course, these criteria should be included in the dashboard, and how a company deals with that. And as in the citation I had shown in the slide before, some criteria regarding resilience against security attacks, or I would extend it to protect how a company protects, how a company detects, and how a company responds to security attacks. So we have some certifications and conformance to, for example, ISO 27000 something on that. This might be options, but I would say not for everyone the results are understandable. So they have to be translated into something which I as a consumer can understand and compare. Another point I would see is privacy efficiency. This means how and if personal data is used necessarily or unnecessarily. How it is used necessarily or unnecessarily. And how would you measure that? There are some interesting approaches to that. For example, an approach on differential privacy, how the authors call it. And I would say the article itself or the content is really interesting, but I would say not many people will be able to understand this article. But anyway, it's worth into looking approaches like that one. And another criteria should be return on data, what the consumer gets back if and when her personal data is used. And this request or this requirement, this right, you have heard about that yesterday in Katrina's presentation, and what she said about minimum collection for maximum value. This is exactly what it is meant. Most probably there are other criteria. This list cannot be comprehensive at the moment. And also all these points which I have mentioned now look like that creating such a dashboard would be a task done through an independent instance, like for example the Stiftung Warentest in Germany for this consumer things. Might be the case, but anyway, I would encourage you to think about which of these topics you can get into your organization, you can get into your company, move forward with that. Because I think each of these points will be a step further to more transparency for the consumer and for you to get to a successful and secure relationship with your customer. With that said, I will close here, and if you are interested in further information and of course in our IBM solutions, you will find some in the final slide. So thank you very much, and I would take the opportunity now to and thank you for your attention at the nearly very last presentation of the day. And I would like to wish you a safe trip home and hopefully see you soon then. Thank you.
Any questions?
Is IBM doing anything for transparency? Is there leading any initiatives in this regard?
There are a lot of initiatives around CIM and transparency in, as I have said, has various views on it, and in several views there are initiatives in IBM, yes.
That's great.